So now we're going to talk about how actually access control is implemented in real operating systems. We're actually going to talk about Unix-like systems, but there's similar things done in other operating systems. Let's focus on Unix-like systems. And so we have to think about users, resources, access permissions, and things like that for us to understand what, you know, how access control is handled by this system. So in Unix, actually every resource for which access needs to be controlled looks like a file. So in Unix-like systems, we also know that users have UIDs, unique identifiers for the users we have in the system. Users, they could also be groups, and certain users could be members of a group. There is a special group that's every user in the system, that's sort of the world group. When we look at access control for a file, we're going to say, well, who is the owner? What kind of access does the owner have? Is there some group that has access to this file? What kind of access that is? And what about everybody? People who are not owner or members of this group. Since resources are files, they can be read, written, or executed. These are the three access rights. So at this point, we know if you think about your access control matrix abstraction, rows would correspond to each UID and each group ID that we have, GID, and the special group world that we have. Column is going to correspond to each file that we have in the system. And if you look at an entry in the access control matrix, it's going to be a subset of read, write, execute. Unix system, the original ACL implementation was actually had a compact fixed size implementation. Remember, ACLs are ACEs, so that's for each user. So the owner is one of the users, then the group would be the next one, and then everybody is the special world group that we're talking about. So it actually had only three, maximum of three ACEs. Actually had three possible ACEs and ACL. It wasn't implemented as a linked list. It wasn't implemented. It was implemented as a bit mask. In particular, we need 9 bits. So the 9 bits encoded read, write, execute for owner. Let's say the bit is on for read. For a given write, then the user has that write. So the user can read it. This is how the compact fixed size representation, perhaps in those days, saving memory was important. So they implemented ACLs using this essentially 9 bits, a little bit more complicated than, but that's the main idea. A few extra bits we'll talk about. Now, this does have its limitations. For example, you know, we can only have these three subjects or principals for whom access can be. Either it's just the owner or just one group or everybody. If we had 10 different users, we wanted to give permission to 6, you know, or 3 or whatever it is, we can't have an arbitrary size access control list with this representation we had here. So operating systems actually now provide implementations of full ACLs, and it's available in many operating systems in Linux, Mac OS, BSD, and so on.